Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. Today in this tutorial, we are going to discuss on various background properties those are used in CSS. So stay tuned. Now in this chapter, we are going to know about different background properties. Those are being used in CSS widely. But before that, I would like to ask you to subscribe us and stay tuned for more. And don't forget to hit the bell icon to stay connected. The things those we are going to learn, how to use different background color, using background image as a background of an element, such as a div element or span element. So we are not discussing practically on span elements here. We will be practically working on div elements, setting the position of that background image, background repeat conditions, and then background attachment. And then we'll be discussing on the compiled version of all within a single syntax. That means we'll be compiling all of these properties into a single syntax and we'll be applying it to our element to see the result. Then there comes this background size here, background color and image together. So we want to use background color and image together. And in that case, what should be done? That will be dealt with here. Then comes this background clip condition and background blending modes and filter properties. Those are very vital things about these background properties. So all those things will be discussed in these tutorials, in these tutorials actually, because it will be hardly taking 2 to 3 chapters and nothing more. And another thing before we proceed on, two things that need to be remembered. The first thing is we have used an image downloaded off Pixabay. The very beginning, what we have done, we have commented off these particular test boxes, those we have created in our previous tutorial. I guess you can remember those boxes there, those blue, yellow and that red box that we have created in, for the sake of our project. We'll be muting them off and we have done it practically here. Now let's proceed into the project. But in the very beginning, I would like to see the output of the project, and here it is. So we can see that this is the position tester box that we had created in our previous tutorial to check on the position of some particular child elements. We have muted these three boxes off from there. The rest of these things is lying here, and we have provided practically a particular height over here. There it goes. We had provided a height of 900 pixels. So all we are going to do in the very first case, we are going to mute it off. There it goes. Now if we get back to our project and reload, we can see that this is practically the output. You can provide another margin top condition over here. There it goes. It's a margin top of 30 pixels from the top right now. Now all we are going to do in the very first case, we will be discussing about this color thing that we will be imposing as a background of the div that we have created over here. And there goes the color. As we can see that we have already provided a background color. This is practically a background color. This is practically the syntax and it's a yellow one. So if we get back to our project and reload, we can see that the situation remains the same. So instead of this syntax background, we will be using a background color, or you may use background, it doesn't differ anymore. Now in case of an image, if we talk about image here, first of all delete it, and now we are going to import an image as the background of our, but in this particular case. So here we'll be using an URL. And inside, the very first thing that we are going to do, this is the folder from where these images are being used into our project. So this is the folder name. First of all, we have to copy this folder name and we will be using it over here. This is the first case. Then comes the backward slash and then we'll be using the image name that will be used over here. So in the first case, we are using this Fox big png image. All we are now doing, we are practically pressing F12, and then along with this extension name, we are practically copying this whole file name from here. So we have copied it and we will be pasting it here. Now that we are set to go, so first of all we will be checking on what is going on over here. Let's get back to our project and reload, and we can see actually that the background color is gone, but there's nothing for the time being. I guess there should be the declaration of this one. Now we can see that the image is practically on, but on the other hand we can see that the same image is being repeated over here. So what is the problem? To stop this kind of repeating properties of this image, all we now have to do, we have to provide a certain syntax. If instead of fox big we now use this fox small, so if we use this file over here, and now if we get back to our project and reload, all we can see that all these images, those are practically being repeated, those are practically the repetition of the same image through wise the element. So we had provided a height of 900 pixels. Instead of that, if we now just mute it off, we will be seeing that what will be the output of it. Let's get back to our project and reload, and we can see that there's nothing else so far. This is due to the fact that this background image is practically dependent on the height of that particular element. That means if we now pour some kind of content inside our particular element, then it will be acting properly. So all we are now going to do, we are getting back to index.html, and here we are practically providing some contents inside it. So I'll be requiring a couple of moments to pour some contents inside it. If you see that this kind of horizontal scroller is appearing, then all you can do, get back to this view section, toggle soft wrap, and you can see that everything is now appearing within the device, within the viewport, and copy it thrice more time such that it gets larger enough. You may change this particular dummy text here. Another thing, I think we have made a mistake. We have placed it outside this div. This is the div, this is the position tester div element that we are practically working on. So we need to place them inside this particular div here. There it goes. Cut this thing, all this content that we have placed inside. And all we are now going to do, we are going to paste it within this particular div element. Now if we get back to our project and reload, now we can see that all those things, those are practically appearing right into our content area, right into the position tester div that we have used earlier. And there goes the problem. We can see that all these images, those are practically repeating in order. In the first case, all we are going to do, we are getting back to stylesheet.css, and here we will be muting off, we will be commenting off this particular display flex. We don't need any kind of display flex over here right now. So press Ctrl S and get back to your project and reload, and we can see that it is now back into order. Now here comes the problem. This is the repetition property of the image that is being observed over here. In order to prevent that, the second thing that we are going to do, we will be using this background repeat condition. And we do not wish to repeat any kind of images over here. Only a single image will be appearing right into that particular div element. So all we have to do, we have to use this no repeat condition. No repeat. Now let's get back to our project, reload. And we can see that this is the situation under no repeat condition. Only a single image appears. In the other sense, if we wish that our particular image, background image actually, it will be appearing x-axis wise, then what to do in that particular case? We will be using repeat x instead of no repeat, and we can see that all the images, those are practically being repeated along the x-axis. In the same manner, if we want our images to appear along the y-axis, then just use this syntax here. Instead of repeat x, we will be repeating here repeat y. Now if we reload, we can see that all those images are being repeated y axis along wise. If instead of them we use this round property, and we can see that this background image is practically now being a circular image practically. If we use some kind of JPEG image over here, we can see that all these images, those are practically rounded in nature. And in the last case, if we use instead of this round, a space, reload, and we can see that there comes the situation when there is a particular space between two consecutive row of repeating images. So these are the properties that you can use over here. Now in this instance, all we are going to do, we are going to use no repeat condition. There won't be any repetition of these images. Reload, and we can see that there's only a single background image present over here.